The Daily Code Snippet. As mentioned before, cross-browser compatibility is the process by which we make sure our code works across multiple devices, platforms, and browsers. Since different browsers support CSS code in different ways, one way to help resolve this issue is to use a CSS reset. This is a set of CSS rules that resets the styling of all HTML elements to the same baseline. When we were looking at the table of contents in a CSS style sheet a few episodes ago, you may recall that one of the first sections of code in that style sheet was normalize. This is an example of a CSS reset. Normalize.css is a set of CSS rules that sets browsers to a baseline of modern standards and is an open source code on GitHub. Another way to make sure your code works on particular browsers is to use conditional comments. This was a common practice when it was necessary to support Internet Explorer, which tended to be the most problematic. These days, we would only need to support Internet Explorer if we knew our target audience is likely to have an older system using this browser. To target all Internet Explorer browsers, you would enclose your code in these comments. HTML, if IE, your code, and if /HTML. To target Internet Explorer 6, we would use this conditional comment code instead. HTML, if IE6, your code, and if /HTML. Vendor prefixes are used to make sure to target particular browsers that may not yet be keeping up with W3C standards and the latest CSS3 releases. These are the vendor prefixes for the most popular browsers. Hyphen MOZ hyphen for Mozilla Firefox. Hyphen MS hyphen for Internet Explorer. Hyphen O hyphen for Opera. Hyphen WebKit hyphen for Safari and Chrome. Finally, we would run our code through an HTML and CSS validator. There are free options available, and these will validate or make sure your code is correct. We will be alerted if we have syntax or any other errors so that we can fix them prior to releasing our code for wide use. Presented by Designers Learn Code.